I'm Jody Olson from the American Society of Plastic Surgeons, and this is your Plastic Surgery Update. There's something about a new year and a clean slate when it comes to finding motivation to lose weight. It is hard work, and there are no shortcuts, including liposuction. It's a myth that the procedure can be used in place of weight loss obtained the old-fashioned way, through diet and exercise. Truth is, liposuction is very site-specific and just for stubborn fat that won't go away no matter what you do.
Well, liposuction is often misunderstood. It's not a form of weight loss. Basically, it's done for diet and exercise-resistant areas like saddlebags and abdominal wall fat, like in males. But it's certainly not a magic wand. I mean, it's done to get rid of unwanted fat that's diet and exercise resistant.
Keeping it off, that's another story. A new study says that obese people who lose weight have a better chance of keeping the weight off if they get a tummy tuck at the end of the weight loss journey. It's in Plastic and Reconstructive Surgery, the official scientific journal of the American Society of Plastic Surgeons. Researchers believe that removing fat tissue during the tummy tuck procedure reduces the production of brain chemicals that stimulate appetite. In other words, fat cells may actually trigger a chain reaction that results in feeling hungry. Now there's a vicious cycle. Subjects in the study who had tummy tucks say they did feel fuller sooner.
I attributed the sense of fullness that patients would tell me and their loss of appetite to this simple tightening of the rectus muscles, six-pack muscles in the midline. But in fact, I think that the subject's more complicated, and it may be involved in gut hormones that are released from the fat, as well as the GI tract that are inhibiting the brain neurons which inhibit appetite. I think we're just getting to the bottom of this subject in terms of how to control appetite.
Also from Plastic and Reconstructive Surgery, more reasons to stop smoking, especially before any kind of surgery. Research shows smokers have significantly higher overall complication rates, tissue death at the wound or surgery site, and are more likely to need reoperation. Complications occur because smoking interferes with oxygen getting to the blood, which then affects the body's ability to heal. It's nothing to take lightly. Many people deny their smoking and have major surgery, not realizing the risks. For more on these stories and other trends in plastic surgery, go to plasticsurgery.org. And remember, for any cosmetic or reconstructive procedure, make sure your surgeon carries the ASPS symbol of excellence, an assurance of the highest standards, the American Society of Plastic Surgeons.